so thankful for the cross. I'm thankful for the Christ of Calvary, and that he's not just somebody that we think about, we celebrate once a year. He lives in our heart. We serve him every day out of the year. Mm-hmm. And I'm thankful for Easter, for the time when the whole world focuses on what was done. They may not really know what they're celebrating, and they may not celebrate Christ at all. But there might be Easter eggs and bunnies and things like that, spring-related items. But they're only possible because God created them. Amen. And I'm so grateful that we serve a risen Savior.
Amen.
You know, I was thinking a few minutes ago that God sent us exactly what he knew we needed. Mm-hmm. We are like sheep gone astray. He sent us a shepherd. That wasn't our greatest need. We needed a mediator between God and man because we're separated. But he couldn't be that before he became our Savior, because our greatest need was to be found. We were lost, completely away from our Savior, from our Creator, and there was no way to find him. Most of the time, a person doesn't find God for the same reason that a criminal doesn't find a police officer. They're not looking for him. But he came looking for us. And, you know, that overwhelms my heart. The love of God is so amazing. Mm-hmm. 1 John 4:10 says, herein is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the propitiation for our sins, knowing that so many would reject him, that they would spit in his face and hate him. But he came anyway. And for those of us who have received him, what joy he puts within our hearts. See, there's nothing like knowing that your sins are forgiven and your heart is filled with his peace. And for me, the only response is, in return, I love you, Lord. Oh, how I love Jesus. And I'm so, so thankful for his sacrifice today.
One grande sea. One grande.
Amen. How great thou art.